think we're online. I think this thing works. Let me triple check my YouTube, see if we're on live. So this is probably the third or fourth time we've multi-streamed to different platforms. So I'm just trying to figure out a simple way to do it. I don't have I do have a Stream Deck, but there's no USB slot for it. Actually, there is a slot for the, I stand corrected. Cool, we're live on YouTube, we're good. Awesome, so I need everybody everywhere, wherever you are, smash that like button so we can get this thing rocking. So the goal of this live stream is to answer any and all music questions that you have, whether it's music business, music technique, anything music related. So I wanted to hop on here. Today's Saturday. Wow, today, it didn't dawn on me that it's Saturday, but happy Saturday. Flizzy T, shout out to you. Deadly Sin is here. What's up? What's going on? Freddie J, how's it going? It's going pretty well. I'm feeling good. Mr. Fallen Hero, how do I become a legend? It's a great question. I was listening to Jay-Z on the way here, and I realized, I was like, wow. Jay-Z put me on to all my favorite producers, Timbaland, Kanye, Pharrell. He put me on to all of them. Jay-Z's a kingmaker. That's what I had to realize. Jay-Z is a kingmaker, and he's done it with everybody. I mean, that's the power of Jay-Z. Shout out to Biz Bennett. Let me go one by one so I could keep up. What's up, Minster? You said good night. Yeah, it is a night. It is nighttime, isn't it? My chat's a little sluggish, so give me a second. What's up, music? Chaotic slaps. What's going on? Young Reza, hey, yo, make that melody by Weezy from the song Friends and Family. I don't know that song. The only thing with YouTube, they don't allow me to play other music to reference. So if I wanted to play it right now as a reference, the whole live stream would just get shut down. So I would do it if I knew it off the top of my head, but since I have to use a reference, I have no idea what the song sounds like. What's up, Board Gamer on Twitch? Samsung says, yo, can we mix two EDM genres together? Yeah, that's kind of like the nature of EDM, is mixing genres. Will X, what's up? Lenny Hill, what's up? Some pop beats. You guys are all over the place. So this is a live Q&A. You can ask any question that has been bugging you or in the back of your head. My goal is to offer you something, okay, because we have a 50% off sale. So my goal in this live stream, I'm being very transparent, is to sell you something. Wow, magic trick revealed. I'm going to sell you something. But the way I'm going to do it is give you clear advice so that you understand I'm not BSing, you know. So for those who are new here, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. I've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, Ariana Grande. I said Young Thug, YG, Ray Shremmer, French Montana, NBA Youngboy, almost everybody on the Billboard charts because they applied the knowledge. Okay, so I want to show that I'm an expert at what I'm saying. I'm not just talking at you. I want you to realize that I actually know what I'm talking about. Where I get like 6 to 8 sounds and create a beat, how do I know if it's done? It's a lot of sounds. Depends on if you're talking about a drum. If you know it, okay, here's the thing. Vocals make it done. So a beat will never be done until it has vocals on it. You could listen to your favorite song right now and listen to the beat. The beat isn't the thing that makes the song, it's the vocals. TJ Timmy, what's up? Chaotic Slaps, I just made my first 2 beats on FL Studio. Shout out to Chaotic. First 2 beats award. Deadly Sin says he needs help arranging beats. Do you have advice on how many bars per intro? Yeah, let me say my hellos real quick. And what's up, Michael? He plugged his whole website on Facebook. You are just straight to it. Not even a hello. Just, hey, my website's this. My merchandise is here. Go to www.michael.com. Just no hello, no nothing. Alien in Space, what's up from Twitch? Derwin is here from Facebook. So we got a multi-platform stream going. I think we're going to have fun here. I'm going to go in order. So if you see me backwards in the chat a little bit, it's just because I want to make sure I'm addressing everybody. So ask a question in the chat and we will have you. So your question is, you need help arranging. How do you, do I have advice on how to do bars and hooks? A lot of guys will try to make this seem like it's rocket science, okay? So let's just drag in a loop real quick. Let's do a loop from 7 Foot G. He has a lot of loops on producercommunity.net. And let me just drag one in. And what BPM is that? Actually, it's not a loop, it's a chop. Let's grab this. And we're at 105 BPM. So the main, you have to understand why we do stuff. So erase the whole, like, what section should go here and understand why we do stuff. The whole point of a song is to go from tension to release. That's the whole point of the song. Tension, release, tension, release. Make the dog want the toy, throw the toy. He brings it back to you. Make the dog want the toy, throw the toy. He brings it back to you. Tension and release, okay? That's the point of every section of a song. So the intro's point is to build up tension because they want to hear the drop, okay? So the intro could be 4 bars, 8 bars. Usually it's shorter depending on if the artist wants it longer or not. 4 bars to 8 bars max. You don't want to go long on the intro because that's where you lose people if it takes too long to drop. Then usually you go straight into a hook idea. And a hook, you want the hook to happen right away because you want to keep people there. The point of a hook is to take people out of their rhythm, okay? You want to shock people into your reality. We all work on rhythms and cycles. And so one thing I do a lot on Clubhouse specifically is when I feel like somebody is just so in their ways and they want to be a student and they want to learn, I shock the crap out of them. And I tell them their reality is false. And I'm harsh. I can be very harsh on Clubhouse sometimes, the way I speak, because I want them to shock themselves out of their reality that's not fully real. Okay? So the point of a hook is to take people out of their reality and pull them into your story. And the whole goal of a song is to keep people in suspended disbelief. Okay? That's the point of a movie. All those CGI movies with the, you know, the fake animated characters. How do we watch a movie and believe it's real? It's because of something called suspended disbelief. Our goal is to keep them in the storyline and not interject anything that takes them away or is in contrast of our storyline, anything that takes it out. So for example, an equivalent of that is you have a drum loop going, you have boom bap drums, and then out of nowhere you hear this lasery digital synth that doesn't sound like it's in the right place. Okay, so it takes us out of the belief that we were listening to a live drummer. Now it's like, where did this random lasery sound come from? And that's what I'm talking about when it comes to suspended disbelief. So once you understand why we have these sections, then you can arrange it how you want it. Usually the energy goes low, very high, a little bit lower, not all the way low. So if this were a percentage, you open the song at 10-30%, the hook's going to be 100%, and the verse is going to be somewhere between 50-70%. The reason I say the verse is at 50-70% is because you want to leave room to go back up again, okay, back up to the hook. Okay, so you understand it's deeper than just like, what goes next? What goes next? What goes next? You need to understand why. Okay, so the intro is usually 4 to 8 bars. The hook is 8 bars most of the time. The verse is going to be 8 to 16 bars, depending on, like, you know, the how fast they want the song. And also remember that songs are made for different purposes. You have songs for TikTok and you have songs for live performance. They're two different songs, two different purposes. So when you have these shorter kind of songs, they have a different purpose, which is to keep people there. So they have to keep the verse short to keep people there. So that's why their verses are a lot shorter. So, you know, you could do different combinations. There's no hard rule for this. But the intro is usually 8, hook's 8, verse is 8 to 16, hook is 8. Okay, then you do second verse, 8 to 16 bars. Then you do hook 3. What hook are we on? Now, some people debate, we really don't have these things anymore called bridges in hip hop. So here's where a theoretical bridge would be, or a B section. I don't know what I just did to my, what did I just do? I have no clue what button I just hit. Oh, that's how you do. Look, we just learned a shortcut. If you hit shift up, you can change the loop. That's, wow, that's in place. I just randomly learned that shortcut by accident. It's ironic during a Q&A. So what was I saying? Yeah, we got rid of bridges. So again, here's the formula if you want to make a cookie cutter formula. 8 bars of intro. Don't go really over 8 bars. Like, if you go anymore, you're going to bore people to death. The hook comes in about 8 bars. And we were just talking about that magnifying glass on Twitter. How do you get rid of that magnifying glass? Anyway, so intro, 8 bars. Hook, 8 bars. Verse 1, 8 to 16 bars. Hook 2, 8 bars. Verse 2, 8 to 16 bars. Bridge is not really used in hip-hop anymore. Why is this doing this? I must have something active because this is not typical. This should be able to move down. I must have pressed the button. Good. What? I don't know what I pressed to where shift does this. Anybody know? This is weird. Because usually shift down moves stuff down. So I don't know what I pressed. I pressed some type of button. So anyway, whatever button I pressed, we will never know. So, and then you wrap the song up with two hooks at the end and then a potential what's called a tag or an ending to kind of wrap it up at the end. So that's your format for you. That was a long, long answer, but wait, it looks like my chat refreshed. So if you had a question from earlier, it looks like my chat like refreshed on me. So I'm just going to pick up where it leaves off. What's up, board gamer? Salute from H-Town. Oh, man, the thing went away. Who have you worked with? Person number one says, who have you worked with? I've trained 700,000 producers. They've gone to work with the top artists in the world. Almost everybody on the Billboard charts. And if I can teach, you know, Joe Schmo how to get a hit record, I'm just multiplying myself because they've applied what I taught them. It works across the board. Okay. And I've also worked with top brands like Razer, billion dollar gaming laptop brand. I've worked with Universal Audio, all the top audio companies. Image Line, who made FL Studio. So that's where I get my joy. It's like watching my kids succeed. Okay. So I want to, because I don't have enough time to be making beats every day. I wouldn't be able to run a business if I did that. Okay. Please make some pads. My live chat's a little fast. So forgive me if I miss your question. It just keeps like changing. Pads, that might take a little bit of time. I might have to skip that question. Can you make a tutorial how to make Hyperpop? That'll take 30 minutes. I have Hyperpop tutorials. Young Riza says, can you just listen to it yourself with the headphones? No, you're making me do too much. What was your birthday? 4/7? Because I just found your email and I was shook. Because same. Hey, Aries gang. Yeah, my birthday is April 7th. Shout out to my wonderful woman, Nicole Nix. Actually, let's plug her website. Because she celebrated with me on my birthday and made me feel really special. And I got to thank her for that. So go to NicoleNix.com, get some vocal tags, buy some exclusive beats. You got to pay for that collab. All right, you got to pay up. But here's her vocal tag example.
Okay, Chevy, I see you. The high class rollers.
And Sonic Branding.
97031 in the booth.
Sonic Branding is known to work.
Oh, Tommy Digital.
Okay, so she has Beats, West Coast Beats, and also does customs. And here's her Instagram, so go follow her on Instagram, too. You got to show her support. You got to treat her like you treat me. If you love me, you got to love her, too. Click here to follow Nicole Nix. We've been talking about Nicole Nix for like 4 years. If you guys really remember during the live streams, we were talking about her since 2018. So she's been super fly since then. Just giving you guys an update. Do you know what BandLab is? Oh, I clicked the button. Hold on. Man, this live chat is disappearing on me. Anybody else? I guess I have to scroll down a little bit. Let me scroll down a little bit. My live chat keeps disappearing on me. Nigel says, I thought you invented FL. Young Riza says, can you show us how to make a melodic trap melody with a string or violin? String or violin. String or violin. I'm trying to think. Let's go to contact. So some of the longer questions that take like 30 minutes to answer, you know, I mean, I got to kind of cut it short. That's what I have videos for. You got to think of questions that I can answer quickly, not like, hey, how do you make a Young Thug type beat? That'll take me an hour. All right. I'm just giving you guys a glimpse of what my brain is thinking. Why is my Alexa?
Okay, here's brain facts.
What? All right, then. Alexa, stop. I don't even know what she heard. What did Lola? So the one thing about strings when it comes to trap music, you want to think about half steps. One note directly to the note or above. Okay, so these are more heavy strings. These aren't violins. I don't think I have any violins in this library, but let's do medium. Maybe medium's a little bit lighter. No, still kind of heavy. So the main thing is you want it to be memorable. I heard from Rance from 1500 or Nothing. He said, if you can't whistle your melody, then people aren't going to remember it. The key to melody is that you want other people to be able to sing it or play it on an instrument. If you make your melody so complicated like this, you know, it's going to like only two people are going to be able to like sing that or play it. So simplify your melody so that it's like a little, think of birds. they just do the repeated little pattern. It goes one, two, 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 two. Okay, it's two-part patterns with the bird calls. And that's how humans are. We think the same way. We're similar to birds. So just little patterns like that. So it's da-da-da-da-da, one, two, da-da-da-da-da, one, two. So it's two parts. One part, call. Second part, response. And that's the simple way to think about melody. Also with trap music, you want to think about half steps going from one note directly to the note above or below. That's the real key to melody. I know it sounds simple, but sometimes a lot of stuff in life is simple. It's just, it's not easy to do it. People want to overcomplicate stuff a lot. So do I make custom beats? No, it takes up too much time to do custom beats. I run a business, so running a business takes a lot of time, a lot of energy. And I'll be honest with you guys, making beats is a luxury. So if you're making beats right now, you are living a life, because it's so hard for me to find time to make beats. Like, ridiculously difficult for me to find time to make beats. I'm trying to load up a library here. Violins. Here's a violin. Forgot I had some Spitfire stuff. Exhale says, for some reason, I can't seem to get my mix to sound as clean as I want. I'm using stock plugins. Well, that's your answer. You're using stock. If you're using stock FL plugins to mix, that's why. What are the best plugins? Waves has a couple bundles. Isotope Ozone bundle. You can't really go wrong with that. It's like a clean start. That's your answer. Government T says, how can I start making beats? I also have a course called Mix Genius. It's actually in the link, or go to busyworksbeats.com/mixgenius. Rich Hunter reminded me to tell you about it. And again, I told you this live stream, I'm trying to sell you something. And before I sell you stuff, I'm going to give you value first. I'm going to give you answers, real how to do stuff, and tell you why it's important, because that's how you sell stuff. You tell people why it's important and then how they can go buy your thing to go get it. So that's why I'm live right now. I want you to buy stuff. Now, I'm not just going to tell you to buy stuff without any value, though. So when I say go to busyworksbeats.com/mixgenius, I say that because in this studio, it's all treated, so I have a more accurate perception of what was happening during mixing. And I'll take a picture. You say you love Nikki's tags? I'll send her that pic real quick. Thank you for your testimonial. Thank you so much. And let me edit this. And I have a course on how to mix. Hold on. I got to figure out what color I want. And send. Hold up, y'all. Thing is freaking tripping. So anyway, in the course, I go over how to mix as a beat maker. Okay, so most of the people you're learning from on how to mix, they show you how to mix songs, and you're not mixing songs. It's different when you're mixing a beat, because you want to think creative and then technical. Okay. All right, I sent that over to her. Your testimonial. So thank you for your testimonial. Why is this taking so long to load? This library here. Spitfire LC. 14 gig library of violins. I don't remember loading this up. I don't even think I even opened this library up before. Whatever. I'm just finding out stuff. So now we're back to the Q&A. And, okay, let's keep going in order. Should I put more effort into making my own beats and releasing them, or releasing sample packs? I say both. Why? Like, when you're making a beat, save the loop, export that, put it in a sample pack folder. So every time you make a beat, you also have a sample loop. It's kill two birds with one stone. Should I put more effort? Oh, I just answered that one. How can I start making beats, and what is sampling? Go to busyworksbeats.com/sample, because I have a whole sample series, and I'm updating the back end so that you have a different set of videos for you, because that's a long answer. Just choose a DAW, FL Studio, Ableton, pick one. There's Logic Pro as well, but most people use FL or Ableton. What dB should I mix at? When you turn stuff down to about negative 12, you have enough what's called headroom. So that's your answer. I know that's a vague answer. Do not think that's the only answer, but negative 12 is usually a good number when mixing everything together. What's good for 808s? Saturation. You want to think about harmonics in the 808. That's what makes it vibrate more, is saturation. Now, there's different saturation plugins. There's way too much to explain here. But again, if you want to learn how to mix beats, just go to busyworksbeats.com/mixgenius. I have a whole mixing course. It's 50% off currently. I have a 50% off sale going. So use the code 50 or 50 anywhere at busyworksbeats.com. It works. And our premium, we have an offer where you can get in for $4. That's crazy cheap. That's less than that's more than 50% off. And then we have different offers on our product pages and stuff. So here's the violin. You just reminded me I had this library. So shout out to your question. I forgot I even had this. Play some chords real quick. You said my beats sound bad in the car. Well, mixed translation is half the battle. And mixed translation means, you know, if I listen to it over my headphones, does it sound the same in my car? Does it sound the same in the studio? So that's a matter of listening to it on multiple devices and trying to figure out the commonalities. Or you got to get a super treated room and really invest in acoustic treatment and all that. Chances are you don't have that budget just yet. How do I make my 808s flow with my melody? Follow the root note of your melody. Don't think about your melody. Think about your drum, your kick, and your 808 as one item. So when you think about your kick and your 808 as one item, you'll have an easier time with your 808. As far as the melody, your melody really doesn't correlate with the 808. You just want to stay in key. That's the biggest thing, though. But what makes beats sound amateur is when the rhythms don't match. Like when the kick rhythm doesn't match the 808, it makes the beat sound super basic and amateur. Whoops, wrong key. Forgot I had these, y'all just really put me on. That's what happens when you like focus on stuff. You start remembering stuff that you forgot. And that's the key to cleaning as well. How do you make a kick drum really hit hard? You gotta push the, what's it called? Where is it at? Let's find a kick drum. So I'll show you, for example. This kick was designed, so it's punchy by default, but the key is hit Control L, send it to the mixer, open up Fruity Soft Clipper or any soft clipper in any DAW. Logic has one, Ableton has one in the glue compressor. Just turn on the soft clip mode. Turn your Ableton compression wet level off, and Logic has one in their compressor. You just have to click where it says soft clip. So with the kick, the key here is that you just got to turn the volume up. I mean, it sounds so simple, but that's it. Just go to your, what is this called? The pre-computed effects button and turn up your boost. Just turn up your kick. Like here's without. It sounds punchy because I designed it to be punchy without slamming it, but you could push it harder. Now, if you push it too hard, it gets scratchy, and that's the sound that I don't like. But that's how you make your kicks harder. There's no like EQ spot. It's just simply pushing it a little bit harder. You can use preamps to do the same thing, but that's the gist there. Let's play some background sounds for you. How can you control the velocity in a third-party plugin? Control the velocity. You right click, go to your piano roll, and you turn down the velocity here. That's how you control the velocity. Now, if you're talking about control the pitch, it's different, and that's more convoluted. I believe I covered that in our FL course, so go to busyworksbeats.com/FL studio to learn more about our FL course. Let me open up some keys so we can play some. What dB should I mix? Negative 12 is a safe dB. If you needed a dB to pick, negative 12 is pretty safe. Let me load up some keys real quick. It's called the MKS. Yeah, here it is. Let's play some gospel chords. Let's answer some questions and play some gospel chords. Here we go. Do you have shortcut guides for gain staging for mixing dependent on frequency? I missed the rest of the question. Yeah, just go to busyworksbeats.com/mixgenius. I talk about gain staging, leveling. I talk about how to mix a beat versus mixing a song. I talk about my mastering chain and my analog. that sounds incredibly good. And I show you how to mimic that in your DAW. I also show you how to, there's like these $1,000, $2,000 units that you, I emulated that in the DAW, and I show you how to do that. Like frequency splitting, for example, I show you how to do that. So you can check your mix. You said, can I make a mixtape with $1,000? Yeah, it depends on how much the beats are, really. And if you can record at home or not. How can I start making beats? What is... Oh, wait. I feel like we answered these before. Is my chat... Wait. I feel like I have the same question. So let me go back to the bottom. Your work is so great, expansive. Thank you. I think I messed up my chat. So if you did have a question, I'm just going to scroll through. Why does it anger me when I watch videos on YouTube and the beat sounds bad to me, like if they use a wrong sound? That's because one thing people don't understand when making YouTube videos is that we're not going to spend 8 hours to get the perfect sounds. We're not. It's just a waste of time. So sometimes we have to like muscle through stuff because like we might pick the wrong sound, but we don't have time to pick the right sound and edit and tweak stuff. It's a different pressure when you have to make a video with no edits in 30 minutes as opposed to spending your good old time for 8 hours and perfecting everything and just chopping up the video and editing it and making it look like it was 30 minutes. That's different. So the people who spend that time to really get it right, you have to have, you know, an empathetic approach to them. Oh, she said she remembers doing your tag padded room. So he's a legitimate customer. Awesome. So shout out to Padded Room. Cool. That's dope. And, I meant to mention these too. I'm forgetting my whole friend's thing real quick. So let me quick mention real quick. This is a mention because I forgot to mention these a while ago. Wavy Wayne, if you know him from YouTube, actually has some headphones. My man's made some headphones, his own brand of headphones, like Dr. Dre. These are called Wavy Wayne Audio Wavy One, isolating studio headphones. And I mean, this is a whole package. Like, this is legitimately his headphones. Pretty insane to me to have your own headphones from YouTube. I mean, he went from YouTube to making his own headphones. So I'll probably rock these around and give you an example. But isolating headphones, I wonder what that means here. I guess, maybe the pads on the sides are isolating. So I'm not sure all the features and the benefits. Features are right here on the side. That looks backwards on your screen. But I'm not sure of all the benefits. Maybe that you can listen to music without hearing people or track with those or whatever it is, record with those. But my man has his own brand of headphones. That's crazy to think. I want to see you guys have your own brands of stuff. So let's get back to the Q&A. So again, I'm answering any question you have about anything really in music, business, or life. But you can keep it music related if you want. Use my pedal here. Let's get some pedal action going. DJ Ray says, if you are mixing your beats, do you always have a compressor first, then the limiter, and then the loudness meter? The thing about loudness is if you're mixing a beat, you're not going for loudness like that. The song that's mastered is going for loudness. The beat is just trying to be loud enough. So you're not going to go for negative 14 LUFS on the beat because the song, the final song is going to be at negative 14 LUFS if you're going by the streaming standards. And I don't want to get into the politics about the streaming standards, but they've proven that they weren't even following their own rules. They were making certain songs louder than others. And I think they got sued over it. Apple Music, I think. So it just shows that even these platforms don't follow their own rules. No, I don't know what that is. Best ways to grow your fan base. You got to add value to people. I learned on Clubhouse, what people respect is people who know what the heck they're talking about and people who give them solutions to problems or have a really dope perspective about stuff or people who are really entertaining. Oops. And those are the people who gain a lot of followers. So if you're not doing any of those following, again, you don't always have to be the expert. Sometimes you just got to be the person who's entertaining or can attract the experts. You don't always have to be the expert. That's the best way to grow a fan base. Other than that, if you're talking about pure entertainment, like music entertainment, you just got to be super, super, super talented. Like those people who make those performance videos. I don't know why it's playing random chords. Your work is okay. I feel like, is the chat refreshing itself? I feel like I'm seeing the same questions pop up. So if I'm skipping your question, I'm not skipping it. And shout out to everybody on all the other platforms, Facebook on in New Zealand. We got Twitch in here. I do appreciate you guys. I'm multi-streaming here. My biggest source of income is BusyWorks Beats. Yeah, I don't have a job. I don't work for somebody else. It's BusyWorks Beats. That's why I said I'm trying to sell you stuff today. I'm trying to show you that I actually know what the heck I'm talking about. For those who don't know, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. I've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, French Montana, YG, NBA Youngboy. There's so many. Basically, most people on the Billboard have been influenced by my teaching, the producers. And that's just the reality of it. So I'm really proud of everybody succeeding. I want to see you guys follow your dream. The biggest question I get is, okay, why aren't you making beats? Beats take a lot of time. And the reality of making beats is you have to make about 300 beats to get about 30 placements if you're making 10% average. And that's tough. You know, it takes a lot of time to do that. And I got to run a business at the same time. So it's two different worlds. So I have to separate myself sometimes. But if you have the opportunity to make music and make a living, that's one of the greatest careers because you're doing what you love every day. Can't go wrong with that. Okay, so back to the question. If I want to build a music label, is the city name in it a bad marketing move? Like what? Like BusyWorks Philly? It just sounds limited. Like what you could do is name it like BusyWorks Beats, for example, and then have subsidiary labels or, you know, child companies under one parent company. So if, for example, it's Michael Gormeiser. Let's just say Michael Music. Under Michael Music, you could have Michael Music Philly, Michael Music Atlanta, Michael Music LA. And that's how you can kind of nest different companies underneath your holding company. And it's not that hard to write. Really, guys, you don't need a lot of paperwork for a label. A label is just people coming together saying, hey, I want to make music with you. Labels don't require a bunch of paperwork, if any. Now, an LLC, in order to like collect money, that takes paperwork, but not a lot. But you would think that starting a record label takes all this paperwork and all this. No, it doesn't. Unless you're talking about copyrights and all that. Trademarks, I mean. The negative 12 for mastering or leveling? Leveling. We're not talking about LUFS. If I say negative 12 dB, I'm talking about just leveling your whole beat. Your beat, your mix bus. My dad is making his own record label. Is it wise to help him with it? I mean, if you're excited about it, go for it. Oh, yeah, I answered that one. Yo, could I ask for some advice? I'm about to graduate. This is from Official Bloodstone. He says, want to ask for some advice. I'm about to graduate high school, and I'm actually not going straight to college. My job is RN My job right now is supporting me enough to afford a small apartment. Am I making a smart move? I don't know your life. I don't know your aspirations, so that's pretty vague. I will say that college didn't lead me to a job. But without college, though, I'm not sure I would have the same polish. You know, college polished up my vocabulary, put me around people who were super serious. I got to see what wealthy kids did, which is a whole experience. I really can't replace the experience of college. It taught me so much social skills. You know, it's a place where you can kind of learn to mess up socially. Like, I can't tell you how many bad pickup lines how many bad ways I tried to get girls' attention back in college that didn't work. So you have to work through all the mess, you know what I mean, to get to where you're trying to go. Now, did I get a job out of college? No, so that's why I started my own business. But if I didn't go to college, I would have never learned entrepreneurship, which is what I'm doing now. So there's gives and takes to college. It just depends. If you have money for it, you don't want to go in super debt for college. I don't believe in super debt for college because that's insane. Like, unless you have a job that will immediately pay off, it just doesn't make sense to have hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of student loans if there's no career even giving you $100,000 a year. But college, there's reasons for college, okay? There's you're going to be around professors who are super bright. You can't get that at home. You can't read that in a book. You got to be around it. You're on the site right now. Where can I find the sample courses? It's in premium if you're talking about sampling. Let me check our do we have a sample course? Now you're making me check my own self. Hold up. Let me go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. We don't have a course in the Shopify store. It might be in our premium. Let's check. So here's what premium is. You can get in for $4. $4. I'm talking about less than a McChicken at McDonald's. McChicken meal. So let's see what our sample course is called. It might just be the sample series. I have so many courses, I literally forgot. You know what? Do we have a sample course? All our sample stuff might be free because I try to keep the sample stuff out of the back end because it's other people's music. I think that's why. So yeah, our sample series, just go to busyworksbeats.com/sample. And you'll get on the mailing list, and the mailing list will guide you through. I actually need to change this. There's so much about running a business that is you guys don't even know. But I'm going to change this picture. But you do get free loops. You get access to the downloads and stuff. And I'm going to guide you through sampling in that sample series. I actually need to re-up the content. So that's what I'll be doing. There's a lot of updates I have to make for BusyWorks Beats. And I know about every single thing. But there's something called priority in business. Can't do everything all at once. So that's where the sample series is to answer you. I received an email from Ayana about the loops I never heard back, board gamer. Let's see. Because we have a whole system. And maybe she just didn't log in. Because again, she has multiple roles in our company. And let's see. Loops for busy. Let's see if you're in that folder. Give me 2 seconds to check. So yeah, if you guys have loops and you want to be a part of the producer community, you can send your stuff to loopsforbusy@gmail.com. I'm just trying to check a tab. And let's see where you are. Awaiting approval. Board gamer. This might be you. I don't want to. There's like a lot of people in here. Hold on. So it looks like there's some unanswered stuff. So yeah, chances are you're okay. So we have a whole system. Chances are she's just up to other stuff. Keep in mind, we have hundreds of people emailing us every day. We got all types of stuff going on. So I only have one person controlling that so far. She's also my team lead, but I appreciate you, board gamer, for reminding us. We have a lot going on. How do I get to where you are at? Wait, how do I get to where you're at? What are the steps? I'll give you all the negative steps. Get your heart broken, sacrifice a lot of your money by reinvesting in the business, do it when nobody else is doing it, do it when there's no pay, do stuff for free, do favors for people that won't ever repay you back. I mean, like, what? You got to just go all the way in. That's the answer I'm trying to say. What's your view on producers releasing beat tapes? I think it's smart. I think I had 8 beat tapes before I had a name. So it took me 8 beat tapes. I partnered up with Hip Instrumentals at the time, which is like the go-to instrumental place. So that's a shortcut. Partner up with people who are already doing it on a bigger scale. How do you gain more followers as a starting entrepreneur? I've learned this from Clubhouse. People want to follow, they only follow people who have the answer to their question, for one, or people who are super entertaining, or if they're good looking, or they follow people who are entertaining. I said that. So you have to position yourself as an expert. Like, what question do you know the answer to? people aren't just going to follow somebody just to follow. Like, that's like saying a girl should date a guy who has no idea what he's going to do in life. She's not going to follow that guy because he's clueless as to what he's doing. So the same thing goes with your followers. Why should they follow you? Where are you taking them? And that's how you get more followers. The quickest way to do it is go to where the people that you want to serve are and then serve those people on a mass scale by allowing somebody to let you on their stage, for example. The shout out WMD, shout out to you. What other questions we got? I feel like I'm playing the same chords too. Y'all ain't never heard that chord before. Putting y'all in a trance right now. Can you pick a hip hop song, a hit hip hop song, and make tutorial for the whole process? Only thing about YouTube, they don't like that. YouTube does not like that. So that's the only thing. I would, but YouTube doesn't like it. What is the best way to get the artist you love that is currently popping at the moment? Your beats. Let me ask you the question back in return. How do I get the girl to pay attention to me that I really want? That's the question I'm going to ask back to you. And once you answer that question, you're going to have the answer to your own question, because that's kind of the same scenario. You're saying, how do I get this girl I really want to pay attention to me and for me to send her a letter? Well, find out where she is. Find out her medium of communication, because not everybody uses the same communication channels. Okay, find out who they're around. You got to build trust in her community, for example. You have to show that you're trusted amongst the people that she knows. Like, is the White House going to let you in without an ID and, like, you know, government official, like, documents? No. It's because you gotta create a name first. You gotta build trust. What is the best... I think I answered that one. Forgot to say it's because I'm going to put 100% into music. If you don't have any money for music, where do you think it's going to come from? Here's the biggest mistake people make. When I started YouTube, I didn't just start YouTube. I had YouTube going for 3 years before I just hopped into YouTube. And that's the part that people don't hear. So I want you to understand that if you don't already have a source of income, jumping off the cliff trying to build a five-figure business is going to be very difficult, especially when you don't have any proof of concept. The same way I can't go to Shark Tank and tell the people to give me a whole bunch of money and then I have no business existing, no sales. They're going to be like, okay, are you crazy asking me for $100,000 or what? And that's what people forget. You have to prove it first. It's a scientific experiment. If you have a theory, you got to go prove your hypothesis first before you continue to push the experiment. And most people are just out here on a whim. They don't know the marketplace. They don't know anything. Go study the market. And what by that I mean, go see where the problems already exist. And if your solution even needs to exist. It's one thing to believe in yourself, but it's another thing to not have a strategy. So if you literally have no income from music right now and you're saying you're going to bet your whole life on music and you have no proof that you even can earn money in music, that's insane. It's the same way as investing money in a stock that has no history. And like, unless you know the people running the company. Thank you. Analog compressors or digital? Which one is worth my money? Just digital for now. It's not that big of a difference to where you would need to spend $2,000 to figure out that it's not that. I mean, it does sound good. Like, I'll run this through a compressor. Actually, I'll run my voice. Oh, wait, this isn't routed right. Darn. Let me load up another template real quick. Okay, check. So I'll run my voice through my analog compressor and EQ. So this is what an analog compressor sounds like. And it's compressing at negative, let's pull it back a little bit. Okay, so this is what an analog compressor sounds like, plus an EQ. Now, since it's more, my EQ is suited for more like vocal recordings, I'll beef it up for talking. So we have the low end back, but this is what it sounds like when thugs cry. So it sounds super cool. It sounds very clear. It doesn't sound like I'm going through a compressor. That's the cool thing about analog. It sounds very transparent, depending on which compressor you get. Now, digital compressors, you could hear it. It sounds like it's pushing down the volume, and it just sounds blurry and dark. Whereas analog compressors, if you buy them right, I'm using a West Audio 11, what is this called? West Audio Mimas, it's called. It mirrors the 1176. That's what I'm using for this analog compressor. It's very transparent. But, you know, if I were using like a, let's compare it actually. Let's go back and let's check. Let's do like a Wave C1. And just ask yourself, do you hear the difference? So I'll compress it. I think I was pulling down. Now, the one thing about the analog is you can push it harder without even knowing that you're pushing it. So I had that. I was going down, negative, like almost negative 10 dB. But when I talk into this plugin, you could actually hear the dB being taken out. Like, you can hear there's something changing. Whereas the analog compressor, you can't really tell. But it's not that much of a difference to where you can... Like, it's not much difference. It's just a subtle texture difference. So in that case, I would say digital because it's a lot cheaper. No need to spend thousands of dollars for like a smidgen of difference. Now, it is a difference though. I will say that. But no need to spend a lot of money on analog stuff. How do I start making money? I'm about to turn 17. Let me go back to my other... Check. There we go. You said, how do I make money? That's a very vague question. That's kind of like saying, how do I get a girl? A very vague question. Money comes from the capacity of energy. That's where it comes from. Money comes from there being a need and there being a solution. That's where money comes from. I know that was vague, but think about that. It comes from the desire to solve something. The same way if I hold a ball over a dog's head and it gets excited and then I throw the ball and it goes to get that ball, energy is exchanged because of the anticipation. So what I'm saying is that money is generated when you build up anticipation and then you let someone expend energy to go get it. Same way a dog gets excited, you throw the ball and it has to go fetch it. That's how money works. You gotta figure out the things that get people anticipating something. Now, there's a gazillion ways to do that, though. There's too many ways to do that. Do we get percentage if we send loops? You mean here? That's if I publish this stuff. Nothing's being published to the distributors. If I were to pitch them, of course. But right now, we're just flipping them to put you on, get people give attention to you. Music says he just selling himself. I unsubscribed. Well, thank you. So that saves me some money. You have to sell. If I didn't sell my courses, my students wouldn't have worked with Drake. They wouldn't have worked with Post Malone. They wouldn't have worked with YG. They wouldn't have worked with Ariana Grande. They wouldn't have worked with NBA Youngboy if I never made them buy a course. Understand? People have to expend and have a sacrifice for them to take stuff serious. You don't get in a relationship with a girl who's not serious with you, who doesn't show that she's gonna give up something, you know, to be with you. So the same thing goes with your customers. Nothing in this world is free. The gas ain't free. The McDonald's ain't free. The air you're breathing is not free. You have to pay for AC. Nothing's free. The free stuff I give out is what I consider alms. It's to show you that I actually know what I'm talking about. But I find that a lot of criticism is from people who never bought anything in their life from me. So that's why I don't take it that serious, because they're not on the other side, so they don't know. How can I make better lo-fi beats? I'll show you a lo-fi trick. Let's record this real quick. Yeah, if you ever hear criticism from anyone on the internet about BusyWorks beats, ask them what course they bought. Guaranteed they didn't buy any. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to make this lo-fi. Just right click, consolidate track from track start. Show you a lo-fi trick. So I picked a lot of high frequencies for one reason, to show you this lo-fi effect. So let's turn this down a little bit. Then right click, go to edit in audio editor. Then we're going to right click where it says sample rate. Knock this down to 8,000 or below. It could be 1,000, 8,000, 16,000. Hit resample. And then it's going to chop out all the high end for you. Let's normalize this, make it loud again. Hold up 1 second. That's going to be super loud. If you want to turn down the volume on Edison, go to your mix level, turn it down. That's the secret there. Here's the same chords, just without the high end frequency. That's called low fidelity. That's lo-fi. That's a secret little trick you could do. We have a lo-fi course at busyworksbeats.com/premium. Shout out to I Am Playoffs for the super chat. Does this tell me super chat? I don't know if my thing tells me super chat on this side, but thank you. Let me answer your question next since I missed that one. Let's see. I Am Playoffs says, how to make 808 flow with my melody and best effects plugins for melodies. Also, my melody seems to not sound right when it starts over. Where am I going wrong? The 808 is, I think people overcomplicate the 808. Most of the time, your 808 is going to act like a kick drum. So when you think of your 808 like a kick drum, it'll make a lot more sense. So I just showed you one lo-fi effect you could do for your melody. Another thing you could do for your melody is load up Fruity Delay 3. Okay, this is one. Turn the wet level all the way up. Turn the dry level all the way down. Turn the feedback all the way down. Turn delay time all the way down. And turn up what's called a time modulation knob. And this will create a wobble effect. Now, why is this? I muted it. So now that's your pitch wobble effect. You don't need RC20 anymore to do this effect. Okay, then you can add a filter to it with a high pass filter, cut off the low end, add a little resonance if you want the little bump in the EQ. There you have the lo-fi sound effect right there. Now, melody is more so about the effects you add to it, like gross beat, for example. You can go to presets and go to momentary. Now, we do have a melody course, okay? So I'm giving you some tips, but there's a whole course on this. It's actually in our premium section. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. You'll see a screen that looks kind of like this. You can get in for $4. I mean, it's cheaper than a freaking McDonald's meal. I made it so cheap for you to at least try premium. So we go over everything from music theory to music production techniques to mixing. There's a lot in here. It's over 33 courses. We've added more business courses to it as well. You can get in for $4. This is what the page looks like. You click here and it takes you to this page. Literally get in for $4. And if you want to check out the courses, you can just click view all courses and it will show you the entire list of everything that's involved. And there's a lo-fi course in here that goes over techniques like this. So the next technique I would use, just to switch it up, is to add momentary half speed. You can slow down the melody. So there's a lot of things you could do. You know, I'm just showing you the basics. You could blend the two together. So now you have a really unique sound. You could tuck the slow speed so it doesn't take over. And who needs RC20? You just need a little vocal, like crackle sound or like rain or something. There's your lo-fi melody. So that's a couple melody tricks for you. For who was that for? For I Am Playoffs. And your 808. So let's use this with an 808. Okay, let's grab an 808. Let's go to 808 Essentials. Where is that here? Essential 808s. So the one thing is, most people pick the wrong 808, like the actual sound. They just pick the wrong sound. You want to pick an 808 that actually matches the vibe you're going for. I don't, that's too much to get into, but we have a course called Beat Magic. If you go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic, I actually think the page might be down. Yeah, we switched the page. So the page is currently down, but this whole course goes over how to make beats from the ground up for beat makers. I'm redoing the product page because we moved off of, what were we on before? We were on WordPress before. So we moved from WordPress over to Shopify. So I have to redo all the product pages. It takes a long time. But this course is all about beat making for beat makers. And that will go through what you're asking about in full detail. Now, to add this 808, think of it as a rhythm. Don't think of it as a note. That's what most people go wrong. They're trying to make a bass line out of an 808. An 808 is an impact. It's like a kick drum. Now, if you're doing R&B and stuff, then you might want to think about different notes for your 808s. Rarely in trap do you change the note for the 808. Rarely. Especially for the modern sound. They don't really change the notes. They act as if the 808 is a kick. So this beat's a little slow, so let's pull it up to 160-ish. And I'll just show you. I'm not even going to change the note value. So see how it's just hitting the same note? Oh, you know what? This is not stretched. Let me stretch this properly. Pull this back to, what is it, 2 bars, 4 bars? Let's do 8 bars, 8 bars. See how I'm just playing one note with the 808, but it just hits right? So just think of your 808 more so like a kick drum than a note, because most people try to get fancy with the 808 notes, and it takes the listener away from the song. So every time I get and I'm gonna do them on a grind that. Okay, so hopefully you get the concept there. That's one mistake I see a lot with trap music. They change up the 808 so much that it takes away from the melody. How to create masterful productions? That's a very broad question, but thank you, Jayla, for your question. Mastery in music production is about sound selection mostly. People get the sound selection way wrong. If I'm making a Travis Scott beat, I'm going to go for the Mellotron type of sounds, or this type of sound, the Celesti, where it can have a dirtier sound, and then you're gonna play minor chords, for example. Okay, so let me turn this up a little bit. So you just gotta know, okay, sound selection, and then what type of music would I play? Like, what type of chords would I play for a Travis Scott? I would do minor chords, like G minor, which is one of your darkest chords. And you have D minor, let's go down an octave. It's weird, because my keyboard is like in two different. It's too short, so I would do, but I wouldn't go upward, I would go downward. And it's knowing, I'm trying to think of the quick answer for this. To be a master, it's about sound selection. That's just the bottom line. That's what separates genres. So for example, you gotta know that Travis Scott sound is based in Mellotron sounds. And Moog sounds, Moog bass. And it sounds like a Kanye sound too. And you have to know Travis took a lot of his influence from Kanye West. Okay, so your sound selection is gonna be the foundation of all things. And then the musicality, the music theory of it all is the second thing. And the third thing is just knowing how to mix it and make it sound like the sound you're going for. That was dope. I did that by accident. So I'm still answering questions. So ask any question on your mind about music, business, or life. Which analog compressor and EQ should I pair with an Avalon 737 preamp? If you're going to go analog, I mean, I like my West Audio Mimas. It's a 500 series compressor. That's the only one I have experience with as far as compression. I've heard the 1176 in studios, but like, do you want to spend 3 racks just to get like a simple sound? Keep in mind, a compressor on a recording chain is not really for mixing. It's for when the artist is listening to themselves sing. It's not for mixing purposes. It's for playback purposes. And then the EQ going in, usually they don't EQ either going in. But an EQ that I use is the SSL 611 EQ 500 series. Again, you don't need that stuff going in. It just gives me the final product, so I don't have to mix it in the box, because I just don't like the plugins sometimes. That's what I use. I mean, you're probably going to get other opinions, but the compressor going in is not really for mixing the vocal. It's for the artist to control the level. That's what it's for. Is gain staging enough before sending out beats for someone who is still learning to mix? I think you're using the word gain staging improperly. Gain staging is, if I have 17 plugins in a row, how do I adjust the volume going in and out each plugin? That's gain staging. Leveling is about turning stuff up and turning it down. That's what leveling is about. Gain staging is going from one plugin to the next. Like, what's the output? What's the input? Output, input. Leveling is just me turning up faders and trying to decide what's more important in the mix. So I think you have the wrong definition for gain staging. That's why you're probably confused. But to answer your question, leave your beats at, you know, I mean, when you're mixing beats, negative 12 is a nice spot to start. You want to have two versions of a beat, a loud version and a mixable version. You don't want to make stuff too loud, because then it's harder to mix. And you don't want to make it too low, because when people hear it on the internet, you want it to hit a certain way. So that's when you would just make it be a little bit louder than usual. Just save the two versions. Real talk. Real talk, man. Real talk. Real talk. You hear me? Talk Southern for y'all. Real talk. This how you like me talking like those other producers on those IG live? Real talk, play, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You just gotta do what you gotta do, you know what I mean? How to create your own sound the best, wait. How do you create your own sound to the best of your ability, you know what I'm saying? You just gotta believe, you know what I mean? You just gotta believe in yourself. Is that the advice you want? Or do you wanna hear from a real expert who has trained the top of the top people in the world, like myself? How do you create your own sound? Sound is about sound design. I was listening to a Luna George album from like 2013. And what was cool about it was that the sound was like something I've never heard before. It was a literal sound, like they've created their own sound. Oh, what's up, Dilio's here? Did I miss that? My bad. Shout out to Dilio T2K. I must have missed it. My chat is a little different on the YouTube, on this little thing. So my fault, Dilio. I did the sample rate thing for a trap melody. It didn't seem to do anything. Why would that happen? Probably because you didn't lower the sample rate enough. Is it because it doesn't have enough high end? Yeah, that too. It just takes out high end. So if it doesn't have high end, there's nothing to chop off. The chat's moving a little fast. Can some people tell him, please, come to help? What? I missed something here. Does it? Super chats? Why is it not showing up on the... So... I'm doing this for free. You don't have to send super chats. I don't want people to... Okay, there we go. So DJ Ray says, here is for you not seeing the first one, but don't forget my birthday. It's the 20th. Oh, there we go. I wrote it down on a piece of paper. It's in my calendar, I think. Let me see. My iPhone calendar. Let me add here. I thought I'd added it in here. But I wrote it down on a piece of paper. Let's do on day... Cool, there we go. I added you in the iPhone calendar. Now, I swear I did that before, but I do remember because I wrote it down on a piece of paper, and it's sitting on that. I know the exact piece of paper it's sitting on. My bad, DJ Wraith. It doesn't show me on the Streamlabs tab that you guys are sending this stuff. This is for yesterday. My B-Day is the 20th. Hope you don't forget. Thank you, DJ Wraith, for showing the love. I appreciate you. My bad if I missed that. Thing. I don't know how Kenny Beats does his chat. Like, Kenny Beats has like 1,000 comments every minute. There's no way he reads all that stuff. Zero way. Maybe I have to set up a way where it tells me about super chats. I don't know. Do you have a whole course just based on trap? We do. It's in our premium section. So go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. You're going to look for the course called Trap Melodies. That's going to be your main course. The UK Drill is also kind of in the trap lane. The FL Beginner course is definitely in that lane. The Modern Melody is for trap. and everything else just depends on what you're going after. But Beat Magic is actually going to be, so go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. Actually, this is the best solution for you. Go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. You can use the code 50. I'll do it right now to take off 50%. Let's hit checkout. And let's type in the code, discount code 50. See how it took off the 50%. So you can get Beat Magic for $20 right now, which is basically a steal. Like literally a steal, because that course is pretty dense. So go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. That's how you get the course on trap. My product pages need to be read up. I know. I get it. It's a lot going on busyworksbeats.com. We got software coming. I got to show you guys the effects too on Ableton. I'm actually going to do that right now because these effects are crazy. Hermes, the new update for Hermes is going to be crazy. And it's good for FL folks and Ableton folks because we have FL effects and we have Ableton effects. So it's best of both worlds. Let me make sure the output here is good. And I'm going to play some Hermes sounds while we do this. Can we hear Ableton? Let's see. Oh, we can. Okay, cool. So we got Ableton up. I'm going to pull up a Hermes patch and play some stuff for those who don't know. So Hermes can be loaded up in any major DAW, Logic Pro. It has the AU, Ableton. It works in here. Works in FL. If VSTs work in Reason, it works in Reason. For anybody on Reason Studios. What is this license about? Okay, so let me load up. Give me a second. Can I get both chats? See if we can get dual screen. Probably not, because I need screen real estate for this. Let's go to a different bell sound. Let's go to bells deeper. Strong. You hear them sound strong. Oh, I'm an idiot. I know what's happening. I'm playing the... Okay, that's what's happening. I'm playing Omnisphere and that at the same time. I'm sitting here like, why does it sound so thick and full? My dumb self is playing two instruments at the same time. Okay, back to the Q&A. So again, let me show you real quick the new update for Hermes, and I'll get right back to your questions. Technically, this is going to answer that melody question. So melody is more than notes. It's also sound effects. That's why I made these sound effects for you. And they are insane. I'm going to pull them up for you real quick. I've been working on these for the last however many days. So we got some Ableton effects for you guys. And we got FL effects too. So one cool thing in Ableton is called a return track. So hit Control-Alt-T to create a return track. And we just got to put effects on it. So this is going to be our first one. Then we could do Twister and probably going to pick... a different one. So this is gonna be Twister. So let me show you what this sounds like. So for example, you could use these send knobs. I've created an ambient lo-fi generator, so you can play any note and it creates an environment. Isn't that crazy? It even creates birds chirping. So I made this for all the lo-fi heads out there. So let me turn this up a little bit. Also, Hermes has a lot of cool features built in. So for example, I have something called spread in here and then with something called vibrato. So now when I play notes, it will spread them out. Literally have an ambience that is custom made ambience. So that I'm really proud of that one. Oh, it looks like my chat is refreshing again. I bust all my instruments. I can't read this fast enough. Let's see. My birthday was 5 days ago, Samurai said. Does anybody use rich drums? I've never heard of that before. So that's the ambient creator. And the other one's called Twister. We have a lot of them here. I have like 20 or 12. Let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17 effects already. Talk about lo-fi. Thank you. really cool effects. It just brings the sound alive. So you already have Hermes, which has a bunch of analog sounds from real analog stuff you can't even buy on the internet. Then you combine that with these effects and it just turns into a monster. Also, you have effects you can add directly to it, which are like Time Mom or Time Twister, I believe, or which one is it? These are very subtle though. So these you can add directly. Big Bells you can probably add directly as well. So it just turns this one instrument into like eight instruments. That's why I love effects. Because you can, now we have a whole new sound. So here's without any plugins. Let's turn these off. Here's the regular sound. I just want to show you what makes melody sound like melody. It's effects, not just the notes. Actually, let's make an arpeggio so you really hear this. So I'm playing an arpeggio so that you can get, it feels more like a melody. Okay, so that's without any effects. Actually, it does have two effects inside the plugin. That's with the arpeggio. Now we're gonna actually run it through the effects, and I want you to hear the major difference with all these plugins turned on. Let's turn some of these back. Some of these are OD. Just to give you a concept. So that's what I've been working on, these effects. They're pretty elaborate. Just wanted to show you that real quick. So that's coming with the next Hermes update. We're not done it yet. Okay, so back to the Q&A. Gotta make sure I'm answering all your questions. So again, the purpose of this Q&A, I'm being direct, is to help sell you stuff. And when I say sell you stuff, I mean convince you that I have the solution that you need. It's the point of this live stream. You know, I would love to sit here and talk about cheese all day, but I'm actually here to serve you so that you can understand I have the solution for you. If you don't know me, we trained over 700,000 producers around the world. They've gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, who else? NBA Youngboy, French Montana, YG, there's so many. So if it works for those producers, imagine what you could do with it. And that's why I'm trying to figure out the best solution for where you're at. So that's why I'm doing this live stream today. This specific live stream. Let's see here. All right, I'm looking for questions. So Michael's spamming his every link on Facebook. Robert says, if I sent you a song I made that has vocals, would you be able to tell me how well the tension and release is? I learn a lot from, and I normally don't need validation, but it would mean a lot. We do that every Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern time. So you want to join us every Friday, 9 p.m. Eastern time. And that's when we do the song feedbacks live. We actually play your song, you get streams for it, and you get feedback on top of that if you're asking for it. Shout out to Aaron. Shout out to Robert. Fredo. What's good for 808s? Saturation. Wait, is my chat showing up? I feel like, is this all Facebook chat? Something's going on Streamlabs right now. How do you make something sound so muddy? 200 to 400 hertz is that muddy range. That's where the mud lives. You can use dynamic EQs to chop it out around that area if you have a muddy track. What's good for 808s? Again, saturation. You want to look at saturation plugins. So is the key to getting the sound I want, that modern day feel, is to buy kits scared of wasting money? Yeah, kits, as far as modern trap, yes. Half the battle is having the right 808. Half the battle is having the right clap. You can get it for free, actually. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/... trying to think of the best link for you. Actually, go to busyworksbeats.com/... Where did I put this thing? I don't know if it's in that folder or not, the Dropbox folder. But go to busyworksbeats.com/trap. The page will look like this. because you need modern sounds. We give you a bunch of sounds for free when you join us over at BusyWorksBeats.com. When you sign up with your email, I don't just tell you to sign up with your email. You get a lot of free stuff. So, excuse me, you can get it there. It's in our Essential 808 kit, and it has this clap. Has this 808, the TikTok 808. Has a kick in there, spins 808, has hi-hats for you. So that's, you need those sounds in order to sound like the records because they use those sounds. It's kind of like, look, if I'm trying to make a Chick-fil-A sandwich, I got to have the Chick-fil-A ingredients. I can't make a Chick-fil-A sandwich from peanut butter and jelly. That's not how it works. That's where most people get it wrong. Biggest source of income is BusyWorks Beats, running this company. I run an education business, I have a sound business, I have a membership business, I have a live events business, which kind of been put on pause, but that's fine. I have a mastermind portion, so coaching business. So it's a lot of businesses all in one called BusyWorks Beats. How do you gain more followers? I think I answered these. This must be glitchy. What's the best way to get the artist? Yeah, I answered those earlier. How long did it start to take you to be able to identify keys by ear? I'm not ear trained like that, so I can't claim that talent. Now Rick Beato, his ear training is crazy. He'll be like A sus, A minor, F major. I'm just like, look, there's no need for me to know that because I'm not a musician, so I don't need to memorize that. Even if you buy new 808 packs, do you still put saturation on it? Not all the time. I mean, it depends on if it needs it or not. Like, there's no right or wrong answer to that. If you want your 808 to vibrate more and sound like distorted, yeah, saturation works. I like the Culture Vulture plugin. Other people like, you know, the Black Box plugin from Plugin Alliance. Other people like the, you know, the Fruity Fast Distort. I don't like that sound. I think it sounds bad. Some people like it, though. So there's no right or wrong. It's just, what are you trying to do with it? I'm a subscriber. I guess I need to download a lot. Yes. How long did it... Oh, I answered this. Yeah, same question. How to make 808s like Pop Smoke. So Pop Smoke 808s are very specific. You want an 808 that's long. Okay, so like a Spins 808, for example. You can get the Spins 808. Just go to BusyWorksBeats.com/trap. Now, 140... I think 144 is the drill BPM. And the thing about drill is that... When you say Pop Smoke 808, you're thinking about one specific song. So always remember that when you ask somebody about a genre, you're referencing one song you know from the genre. Not every song has the same exact 808s. However, you're asking about Pop Smoke. So the key really is about the 808 slide at the end. And I'll show you guys real quick. I teach this in Beat Magic as well, which is BusyWorksBeats.com/beatmagic. We go over different genres. And again, I understand it's not the sexiest sales page because I need to make another one, but it looks like this. You can use the code 50 during checkout to get it for half off. Just type in the code 50. Okay, so hit checkout, type in the code 50 and discount, it will discount it for you. So we're doing a summer sale. So that's why I'm answering all these questions so that you can get clear as to how I can help you. Okay, so anyway, here is the rhythm for drill. That's a little low. Trying to think of a Pop Smoke sound. Now we're doing this without the drums because I don't feel like drawing in a bunch of hi-hats and all this. Actually, we don't need to do too much with the hi-hats. I'll show you real quick. Let's open this up. Now the hi-hats are very simple. It's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. It's just repeating the same pattern. So the main key is the wah 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 that you're talking about. So what you do is you copy these notes, hit shift, grab these notes, hit control up, pull them up 2 octaves, okay? Then you want to double click on each of these notes and make them a slide note. So here's the magic right here in FL. This is what makes FL the GOAT, is because of this function right here. So double click on these higher notes, change it to slide notes. Now highlight these, hit control, hit alt, left click and make these really short. So the top notes need to be shorter than the bottom notes. That's the key. And that's how you get that slide sound. So if you don't want it that high, you can pull it down an octave. Just won't have as much grip. See how it just sounds like whoa, 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 whoa. So that's why people, that's how you get that Pop Smoke 808 slide. We teach that in Beat Magic, and we go into depth about the UK drill. We even have a free UK drill course. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. You can actually get it for free. Just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. It's absolutely free. Just got to sign up. Click on the UK drill. You can get it for free. It's a free drill course for you. Thank you, Mandeep. I will smile for you. I didn't eat anything yet, but I'll smile. Thank you. Thank you. I do appreciate you guys. I was saying to the beautiful Nicole Nix. Let's go to NicoleNix.com. NicoleNix.com. Get your vocal tags, get custom beats. Support her because we're trying to make her rich. Click here for vocal tags. And I'll play a little demo of her vocal tags.
Okay, Chevy, I see you. The high class rollers. 97031 in the booth. Oh, Tommy Digital, you called for this.
Sonic branding is known to work. That's why they have Alexa. That's why they have Siri. I'm trying to not let my Alexa hear that I'm talking to her. Okay, good. And they have Siri. So that female voice is known to get people's attention. It's called Sonic branding. But also you can get, and she has a really good voice, Nicole Nix. Really sweet voice. She also has beats if you're into buying beats. Custom beats, collabs. Here's her Instagram, so go follow her. Is what a Shopify page? Is my page a Shopify page or is her page a Shopify page? I think we both use Shopify. And here's her Instagram, producer_NicoleNix. _NicoleNix. And I was like, look, when I marry you, girl, we're gonna have a lot of people at this wedding because there's so many people who love us. And I wanna figure out a way to be surrounded by love, like real, dedicated people, as if you're my family. Her page, I think it's Shopify. Here's a way to look. So let me give you guys a secret. So for example, if you wanted to know if her website's made by Shopify or something, you just right click the website, go to inspect on Google Chrome, go to sources, and then you should see the site name over here. So it's Shopify. You could do the same thing at busyworksbeats.com. You could also see there's some elements hosted by BeatStars, which is the music player. So for example, you can go to my website and you can see I'm using all these tools under the sources tab. So you can see I got Shopify, I use Loom, I use, what is this? Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, YouTube. So that's how you look at what people use for their website. Unless it's like a custom PHP file, then it's different. Okay, so that's that. That's my tech knowledge for the night, because I don't know much about tech. You funny. Where we at here? Free UK drill is not opening. Did you sign up? You got to sign up first. What do people mean when they say Sonic sounds? I want Sonic. Oh, you know what Sonic means? It means Sonic is what you hear when you run your stuff through analog. Like, I'll give you an example. Let's pick a song that isn't run through analog. So let me think. What song do I not have going through analog? So I need something from before I was even in this studio. I know all this stuff is from the studio. I think this might be. Say some new, I'll say some new, I'll say some new. I think I made this in my house. I think. Let's do the Lil Wayne mixtape actually. Okay, so what I have to do is open up another template. I'll show you what people mean by Sonic. So let me load a project for you real quick. Because for the longest time, I was like, what are people talking about Sonics? Like, what does that even mean? Like, I used to think it was like a term people used that didn't know what they were talking about. But once you get analog gear, you hear what they mean by sonic. It means that the mix becomes an instrument. That's what they mean by sonic. Okay, so let me show you. So here's before the analog stuff. Hold on, let me figure out how to pull the chat back up. So this is a song I made back when I was live streaming from my house.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we just said shawty. Told y'all before, I'm already that. Yeah, captain of the ship, I'm already black. Yeah, they call me Black Flaggin'.
Okay, so you hear that beat? Now let's run it out to the analog. I might have to turn a couple knobs. But now you're going to hear what I mean. It means by sonic. You could actually, like, the mix becomes an instrument. Yeah. All right, so there's a couple things I got to fix here. Just give me a sec.
Yeah, we just said shawty. Told y'all before, I'm already that. Yeah, captain of the ship, I'm already black. Yeah, they call me Black Flaggin'. I'm blowing fire like a dragon. Man, I'm swaggin', Wayne the dragon. Yeah, currency, the hot spitter for show. Riding in the low low, for show. Man, have you ever seen greatness? It came from the game, I mean, a nigga so elated. We are not cousins, but we brothers and related. We are so elated, I feel celebrated. Yeah, currency came from Lil Wayne's album to the name stump to the main stage. 5,000 screaming my name. Currency in the low low with that rider chain.
Here's what it is, I ride with my clique. Here's what it is, main on the shit. I said it is what it is, I ride with my clique.
So you can hear there's like a difference. That's what sonic means. Now this track was already kind of mixed well, but sonic is like when you can feel the music. It's hard to explain until you really hear the difference between analog and digital. I'm trying to give you somewhat of a gist. Oh, let me run that back.
Yeah, captain of the ship, I'm already black. Yeah, they call me Black Flaggin'. I'm blowing fire like a dragon. Man, I'm swagging. Wayne the dragon. Yeah. Currency, the hot spitter for show. Riding in the low low, for show. Man, have you ever seen greatness? It came from the game, I mean, a nigga so elated. We are not cousins, but we brothers and related. We are so elated, I feel celebrated. Yeah, currency came from Lil Wayne's album to the name stump to the main stage. 5,000 screaming my name. Currency in the low low with that rider chain.
Here's what it is, I ride with my clique. Here's what it is, main on the shit. I said it is what it is, I ride with my clique. Here's what it is, main on the shit. I said it is what it is, I ride with my clique. Here's what it is, main on the shit. I said it is what it is, shorty, that's for sure. Cause it is what it is when you got the dope.
It's Lil Wayne, that's for sure. Tell him be up the pieces. Yeah, for sure. Tell him.
So that's what sonic means. It means like you could feel the track. Okay, so that's what it means. You probably won't hear sonics until you get in a treated studio or until you have analog stuff. You just won't understand what sonic means or understand what people are talking about when they say that. That's my opinion. So I missed a lot of the chat. Let me scroll back up to the top. One pack I got from You Busy had a sound effect from 2010, but I still made a fire beat. There we go. Yeah, I want to re-up all my drum kits too. Because I learned a whole new way of doing drum kits from absolute scratch. Not curated sounds, not edited sounds, but absolute scratch. Make a beat using the 808 drum kit. Oh yeah, I've done it plenty times. The monthly subscription is $4 to try it for the first month and then $19.99 after that. You don't have to be famous for it. Wait, oh, you're talking about DJ Wraith. Where can I purchase your pack? Pack of what is the pack you're looking for? You talking about sounds or you're talking about pack of courses? I don't know. Just go to busyworksbeats.com. That's where everything is kind of housed for the most part. Or any links in the video description. Piano plugin as well. Piano plugin, I mean, you could look for Expand too. This has pretty cheap generic sounds in it. Like, let's see, piano, let's do this. And I'll even show you with, oh no, we exited out of Ableton, never mind. I was gonna show you with the new Ableton effects. You can make any sound good. So, I mean, they have generic pianos, you know, the acoustic piano sound. This is like your generic go-to. I mean, Dilio plays. I dabble. Dabble. So that is a plug-in for you if you're looking for pianos. My chat keeps like reloading in chunks, so I'm not sure what I'm missing here. So preamps and analog compressors are more effective for podcasting than recording vocals. Preamps and analog. I mean, think about a compressor. Like, you're not. What people are doing with the compressor, again, is they're just really hearing themselves through it. It's kind of like auto-tune. Unless you just want to mix it going straight in, that's a different thing. Depends on what do you need a compressor for. Like, just ask yourself, what do I need a compressor for? Am I just trying to get a compressor because I want one, or do I actually need one? I don't need a compressor to talk loud in this mic, but I sound like it's pretty radio ready because the leveling's good. The gains, there's no gain staging to be really, because it's just a preamp. The preamp's good. The mic's good. I'm not clipping. I don't really need a compressor. Like, unless I wanted to shout or something, like, do you really, really, really need a compressor? I think we tend to, like, think we need all this stuff. Here, I'll add a compressor. Let's do an 1176. Where is it at? Teletronics, right? No, UA, duh. And here's an 1176. Let's put it on a preset. Let's say vocal limiter. Vocal limiter. So now my vocals are super slamming. Actually, that's too much compression. Let's do gentle vocal compression. All right, there we go. So now I have a compressor that I really don't need. It just makes my voice sound more pushed down. And then let's add an EQ that everybody thinks they need, the SSL EQ. Do I have this one? I think I have this one. All right, let's add the EQ and let's turn up the high end so we can get a nice little sizzly sound going, a little 5K. If anything, an EQ. Because you want to boost, like, especially the lows on the male, you want to boost that so it sounds more enhanced, so that you'd be like, oh, I got that radio voice. You can boost it like this. A lot of people overly boost at 100, and it sounds like this, you know, welcome to Johnny's Rib Shack. Here we're live in the Decatur Hills. Like, you don't need that much low end. I don't really like that much boominess, but some people do. And then you could EQ out the muddy spots so you can get the mud out of there around 400. So EQ is more appropriate, I would think, for a podcast. Compressor, you don't really need a compressor, in my opinion. It just doesn't do much. Here's without the compressor. Check, check, check. Here's with the compressor. I mean, like, did it do that much? Or do you just hear my mouth a lot more clearly? Like, my spit sounds, you know what I mean? Like, do you really need that much intimate detail about my vocal? So it depends. I'll just say it depends. I guess there's no right or wrong. Hit the like button. Appreciate you. Would I get more recognition for being the creator of a genre or becoming famous for something someone has already done? I mean, did Drake invent hip hop? No. That's your answer. Drake's the most famous artist probably to ever live since Jay-Z and Michael Jackson. Did Michael Jackson invent pop? Did Drake invent hip hop? Nope. That's your answer. Okay, I'm a little back in the chat. What do people mean when they say, oh, we answered that one. Can you teach about stereo widening? Yeah, most people overly do stereo widening. So think about stereo widening as a V shape. The plugin that will help you is called S1 because it shows you what the stereo field is. Things aren't just left and aren't just right unless you have mono signals. Now, most synthesizers like this synth has a spread image. It's not just dead mono or dead left or dead right. It's like an in-betweenness. That's called the stereo field. So the stereo field, you want to manage how wide the V is. That's what he said. Or no, that's what she said. And did I ruin it by saying he said first? Whatever. That's what she said. So open up S1. And I'm going to exaggerate this V shape, like how wide it is, by making it really wide. So now it's like fully spanning my speakers, left to right, all the way. Let me mute my mic so you don't hear all this clunking that I'm doing. Okay, now let's pull the stereo image mono, which means dead, one lane, dead center, mono, one voice. So I did that last exercise to show you what width means. Mono's dead center, and then you could widen it out with like a V shape. So that's stereo imaging in a nutshell. You know, there's a lot more to it, like phase and all that. But again, I'm here to tease you so that you can go buy a course so that you can learn a lot more. You can actually learn a lot more in our Mixing Academy. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/mixing. You can learn more there. And that will teach you more so about mixing. Do you leave monetization? Oh man, the chat just disappeared on me. It said, do you leave monetization something? I didn't see what it said. I lost it. Darn. My fault. My chat disappeared. Let me scroll back to the bottom so I don't miss all this stuff. Like this round. Okay. Can I ask what type of analog gear were you just adjusting on? It's a lot of stuff. I mean, I'll quickly name it, but it's a lot of stuff. So. Okay, I got the Neve 542-500 series. I have a stereo pair. I have a Wes Audio Dione, which mimics the SSL compressor. I have the SSL Fusion, which is really good. I have the Drawmer 1974 EQ. You really don't need that one. And that's it, really. Yeah, that's actually my chain. I thought it was more than that, but that's it. I have other stuff, but it's not in the same chain. That's my mix bus chain. Best free quality trap drum kit. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/trap. You can actually get it a lot of sounds for free. So you don't have to worry about finding the best kit. Just get a ton of sounds, thousands of sounds. Can I ask what type of, okay, answered that one. Are MIDI chord packs worth it? Let me show you. Cause I'm working on adding more MIDI to our collection. And let me show you, you're gonna get a sound that you just can't get anywhere else because my brain and chords is magical. So you get to enjoy my magical brain and how I do chords and how I play the chords. Let's load up a Rhodes. And I was just messing around one day and I recorded these MIDI. So let me pull them in real quick. Or did I play some? Yeah, MIDI. Just to show you the like how crazy these MIDI are. This is the power of MIDI. So if you don't know how to play, you can get chords like this. Oh wait, let me slow this down to one something. I don't know why the volume's so high. Should not be that aggressive. Oh, I think I need the MK, that's why. So also keep in mind, when you play E-pianos, how hard you play the notes dictates what it sounds like. I think I played the chords on this piano. Like, are you gonna play that by yourself? Chances are no. That's what MIDI packs are for. It's to get stuff that you just don't wanna play by hand. It's like having a session player. Pull this down. Okay, so that's the power of MIDI. It's similar to having a session player play something for you, but instead of just them playing it for you, you can change the instrument or change the timing of stuff. So that's why we record stuff in MIDI. I've even had a guitar player record MIDI with his little, like, he can record MIDI through his guitar. Hey, did you secure a time for the meeting on Telegram? Shout out to, I want to say Tim. I remember the INMF. Did the group vote? Let's see what the group voted. So we have a new mastermind for all the people who are in premium. If you don't know, which you probably don't because y'all don't read. If you go to Mastermind, click here. It's going to take you to a page which has a link to the Telegram group where you can join the Mastermind. All you got to do is become a premium member. We're doing it only for paid premium members right now. Let's read what the Mastermind says. I haven't read these all day. And Tim says, 7 p.m. on weekdays, and I have open availability on weekends. See, the difficult part, Tim, I'll tell you what happened. Calendly was not showing up for my other teammate, so she couldn't check when you guys had meetings, and she was the one who was supposed to hold the meetings, not me. So it became a conundrum to figure out why the meetings weren't showing up. So then I decided, let's just all do one big group meeting to knock all the meetings out of the way until I could figure out why her thing's not showing up. So 7 p.m. on weekdays and weekends. Alondra says, I'm available usually around 2 p.m. on most days. And Tristan says, as long as it isn't 1 to 3 p.m. Pacific time, this upcoming Monday, I'm good with any day and time. Okay, so that's why it's like being a manager is time management is a whole thing. If you are a manager and you do any type of time work in the books, pray for your peace because that is a crazy job. So that's your answer. I'm going to give people an answer tonight. So remind me in the chat so I don't forget. Then we'll do the onboarding calls for the Mastermind. And I want to introduce you guys to really cool folks. People have to join the daggone Mastermind. They don't even know how to get there. So if you're a premium member and you didn't know, go to BusyWorksBeats. Actually, go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Click on where it says Mastermind and join the Telegram group because I'm trying to introduce you guys to a lot of cool folks. But y'all don't want to join the daggone Telegram group. They're like, if it isn't Discord, I'm not going. I'm just like, Telegram is for VC investors. Okay, is Beat Magic in the subscription? No, it's standalone. You got to go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. Expand Hidden Gem. This is Nafi who makes the West Coast beats. Does buying features work? I look at, if I were to buy a feature, I'm looking at it like either I really love their sound or I want to get in front of their audience and I want to try and convert their customers over to being my customer. That's the only time I would buy a feature. I look at it like advertising. But not everything's about money. Sometimes it's just the right voice on the track. Yeah, features happen a lot. Sound selection for lo-fi bassline. You could use Trillion. Trillion's very good. I don't really hear a lot of bass lines in lo-fi. I think lo-fi is kind of like the absence of bass from what I've heard. But if you're going for like, you want to think acoustic instruments. So you have something called Trillion, which you could load up in Omnisphere. And you could load up a simple one called Clean Fender Full Range. This is just a nice clean bass. But like lo-fi doesn't have a lot of bass like this, from what I've heard. Tay Zonday, that's funny. Chocolate rain. Every time I see the bomb again. Singing and playing is like half impossible. I don't know how you do it, Dilio. Singing and playing at the same time. It's like rubbing your head and what else do people do when they rub their head? Chocolate rain. Every time I... never mind. NASA on the hunt for a bass drop. All right, so ask your questions. We got, 15 minutes left? Are y'all getting bored? It's Saturday night, 12 a.m. We could do a cook-up after this. Maybe I'll do that to kind of wrap it up. You can speak further from the mic with compression? Technically, yeah, but who wants to hear all the background noise and the this and the teeth and the mouth? Not me. Bruno, no, I meant business-wise. Well, buying a feature from someone with 40,000 followers to advance your career, there's no guarantees. The main thing is, do they have the audience that want what you have? Like, there's no point in me performing in front of country folks because they're not gonna like my trap beats for the most part. So there's no point in me performing. So there has to be a similar audience. That's the only time. And just because somebody has 40,000 followers doesn't mean they have buying customers either. I want to mix my vocals so my voice isn't recognizable, sounds fake. What's the best vocal mixing chain for that? That is very random of a question, but you have something like MicroShift that could do that. You can use pitch bending plugins. You could use a little Alter Boy. Anything from SoundToys usually will get you there. There's other plugins like vocoders and stuff like that.
So this is how they get that anonymous sound, I remember he pulled up in the back and he took my money, and you know those like blacked out images on all the crime shows? This is how they get that sound. It's basically like, he didn't do it. You know, he didn't know what was going
on. I don't even know how to talk like a crime show. That's how they do it. It's called a formant filter. I want to mix. I answered that one. How can I be more confident in my music? Do more music. Put it out there. Put it out there and just do more music. You'll start to realize like music is just, it's a moment. And the more moments you capture, the more confident you'll be because you have more results. Is there any free plugin or effects you think everyone should get? Anything you pay for? I have videos on best plugins. There's too many to name right now. Just type in best plugins BusyWorks beats. It's a whole video. And the video took me longer than I expected. That's why I had to cut that question short. Because the video takes a long time to get through all the options. Studio looks crazy. It is crazy to have a studio. Show us how to make a J Dilla bass. Use Trillion and play a live electric bass. Just play it with rhythm. Like, that's not something you could just type into the piano roll. Put it back to white stereo. Why is the bass better in mono? That's not necessarily always true. I actually made a beat once with my bass in stereo and it sounds better than the rest of my beats with the bass in mono. Yeah, don't follow people's hard rules for anything. Like, if people tell you to always do something in music, they're probably always wrong. There's no always in music. Even when they told you not to clip, they were hit songs that clipped. So, I mean, if you have hard rules in your head, you got to get them out of your head. It's going to be the hard part, because I remember when I was told never compress more than 4 dB. And for like 4 years, I was never compressing more than 4 dB. And I was like, why don't my vocals sound the same way as this person? The other person is squashing their vocals negative 20 dB. That's why. And I wasn't compressing enough. So just take the dumb rules out of your head. Do you use S1 on the master or separate channels? I don't really like S1, to be fair. I was just using that as an example. But you would use it on both. Depends on what needs widening. If the whole track needs widening, you could put it on the mix bus. If you just want one sound to be wider, you could do it that way. It's both. Kareem, what's up? Can you make an EP for Justin Bieber type beat? I don't know what EP means. What does that mean? Episode? I keep playing the same chords. This is like all I know. I'll just play one chord. We need good questions. Hit me with the good questions. I'm here to answer your questions. You answer me. Let's see, let's pull up the roads. Sounds like a Discovery Channel special. I'm gonna zoom the chat to the bottom because I know I'm missing a lot. Kid Mitch, what's up? True, I was counting seconds for just for no time. It's counting seconds for just no time. I don't know what that means. down can be perfect for painless. I'm losing the context there. Yeah, let's cook up. Okay. Rubbing your head and your stomach at the same time. Yeah, the question's kind of dried up. Q&A is usually not the most exciting thing ever, but I wanted to make sure that people knew that I knew what the heck I was talking about. That's what this was for initially. And let's do this. How to use Omnisphere is a very broad question. You just type in keywords and pull up sounds. That's what I do. I use it like Google. I type in the keywords and just click whatever is there. Dance hall, S1. Yeah, I don't know what the deal is for Waves S1. If I play, for example, C major for the chord. Okay, C major. I must play the same. Wait. If I play C major chord, I must play the same key to the melody and the other sounds on the track. You need our music theory essentials course. That's the answer, because it's too much to explain right here. You can use what are called borrowed chords. Actually, just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium, because we have music theory courses in our premium too. That'll give you what you're looking for. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. You can get in for $4. Super cheap to get in. I made it affordable so people could try it at least. It's cheaper than a daggone Wendy's meal people order. But to answer your question, you can use what are called borrowed chords, aka chords that are not in the scale. Like, for example, this chord right here is not in this scale. But it's called a turnaround chord or borrowed chord, because it pulls away from the scale and then puts us back in the scale. So that's an example of a chord. Like, I'll do it again. This chord's not in the scale, but it sounds good. It just has to resolve, it's called. So you can do cool stuff like that with going outside of the scale. So I don't want you to get too locked into the scale, because scales aren't the end all be all. I need y'all to smash the like button if you want me to do a cook up. Because if we're doing a cook up, I need at least 80 people in the room. And it's showing me only 66, which is not a big enough party for me. I like to perform. So you could also do, let's see, what is another? That's a borrowed chord. So with scales, it's okay to go outside the scale, but you have to know what the purpose is. There, you could use key modulation, it's called, borrowed chords. We teach all this stuff in our music theory essentials. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/music-theory-essentials. It'll pop up. Yeah, you gotta be in the moment. Do you think FL should introduce freeze track like Cubase? It does have freeze track. Well, I don't know, it's considered freeze track functionality, but you can right click and consolidate the track from track start. So you can freeze it into audio and it'll keep the MIDI. So technically that is a freeze track. Yeah, they already have that. What is the best free format filter? I don't know any free stuff. I'm not the free plugin guy. I used to collect a lot of free plugins, but I just don't anymore. This just doesn't. I don't want to eat up my space on my computer. What do you think about selected music style? Is it the new mainstream? I don't know what that is. The selected music style. Is it the new mainstream after Big Room and Future Bounce? I think here's my take on all those like subgenres. Is it's like cryptocurrency. You know, like one cryptocurrency could be popping today, another one could be popping tomorrow. But at the end of the day, pop music will always reign as pop music. Hip hop music will always be the Bitcoin of crypto. So it's like all those other subgenres are just quickly moving. They go up quick, they go down quick. Like, we don't really jam to dubstep anymore. Did anybody realize that? We don't jam to dubstep anymore. Like, on a major, like, major market scale, we're not playing dubstep anymore. which was people thought it was like the second coming of Christ, but we don't listen to it anymore because it was a trend. Now, of course, people still make dubstep, but it's not on the charts anymore. It's at festivals, yes, but it's not on the charts anymore like that. Because EDM tried to steal trap, and that's what they get for committing that crazy sin to steal trap. They really tried to hijack trap. It was, if you know, you know. Okay, let's answer two more, and then I'll get to the cookup. If 80 people get in here, if 80 people aren't in here, I'm not gonna waste my time doing the cookup. Playboi Carti, try another. Don't sound good. Can you tell me what that sample was from your Lil Wayne? It was from Tracklib. Dang, I don't know what the sample was. The song was like Love Me or Leave Me. I don't know, to be honest. It's from a live stream from a really long time ago. Let me see if I can find the video so you can see. At least I have the record of the video on replay. So I want to say, what did I name that video? Was it Lil Wayne? I forget. I just looked it up not too long ago. No, not Carter 5. Here it is, I think. So it's called Producer Cookup. It's called Producer Cookup Mixtape Series Lil Wayne. That's the video. And the sample, let's see if we can go back. The sample is, that's not the record, is it? It's called Love Me. Hold on. If I can't find it in the next couple seconds, I'm not going to obsess. But watch this video if you want to find out where the sample came from. It is, okay, here it is. It's called Love Me or Leave Me by Band of Thieves. Love Me or Leave Me, and that's on Tracklib. Love Me or Leave Me by Band of Thieves. That's where it came from. So that's that. That's why I record everything as much as I can, going live and stuff, just to, sometimes I'll be like, dang, what was that one sound I had? And I'll just rewatch it. Sometimes I'll be like, how did I make that beat? Like, I was on something else that day. Freeze track and consolidate are different. Ableton. Oh, I don't know the exact difference then, my bad. I mean, I don't really need to do it. Maybe you have a lot going on. No, man, sorry for your CPU issues. That's why I don't use free plugins, because it's too much CPU crap. They don't really focus on DSP. Waka Flocka. Yeah, they even stole Waka Flocka from us. Our great Waka Flocka. So if the chat doesn't get up to 80 in the next 3 minutes, I will end it, because cookups kind of need an audience. And I feel like we've been going for 2 hours, and the chances of people watching the end of a stream are very slim. If I did a cookup, what type of beat are we going for today? I'll let you guys vote. So if we're doing a cookup and you give me a good enough artist or a good enough sound or something, a good enough genre, then I might do it. But if it's just like trap beats, I've done that 1,000 times. How do you do that in Reason? How to do what in Reason? I don't know. I'm not a master at Reason. I can't give you that answer right now. Lo-fi, boom bap. Facebook, I don't know what's on Facebook. It shows me the chat here. Best free plugin, I think Expand 2 is free for a little bit. Yeah, I have people what is classic China Tower music? I've never heard of that before. He said make some classic. Some classic Chinese. Ruben Stutter type beats. Y'all are wildin'. Dark R&B, Weekend, Pharrell. Pharrell, J. Cole. We could do J. Cole to celebrate J. Cole. Boom Bap. Lo-fi Weekend type beats. I do owe somebody a Weekend type beat. I told them I would do that. Weekend style is just so basic. It just bores me to death with the simple chords, and it's just too minimalistic. It's like not even fun to make. but I might do a weekend thing. How do people make house beats with the build-ups and drops? Learn about the transitions and automation. That's my answer to you. There's a lot more to that answer, but I have videos on this stuff, y'all. Like, type in drops, BusyWorks beats. Anything you have music production related, I probably did a video at some point in time. So if you need help with drops, type in drops, BusyWorks beats, and it'll pop up. So I'm not getting a like consensus on a genre. I'm seeing lo-fi a lot, but do y'all really want me to make lo-fi? Like, it seems so boring. Darkness, maybe like dark R&B or something like this. Bryson Tiller type. Tropical House, some Justin Bieber type beats. That came and went extremely fast. Neutralized drill, what is that? Never heard of that. Chill wave. I do need to brush up on my EDM genres. I haven't made EDM in a while. So I could try EDM tonight and fail completely, or I could do typical trap drums with R&B chords. Summer Walker type beat, really? I always thought that the Weeknd songs were maybe the one I'm referring to. I'm just referring to a very specific song in my head. So let's try a new hand at EDM. So I'm going to take my headsets off, and I have to turn my mic down because you hear the echo. It'll echo crazy. Let's do some EDM type stuff. We'll do like EDM slash drill. We'll call it electric drill. Is that corny? Let's do some electric drill, y'all. First off, we got to come up with some sound. So let's pull up Serum, which is like the EDM guys's favorite plugin ever. And J. Cole Beats is trending in search. Maybe I'll do another video about J. Cole. I think I did one already, but it didn't post yet. Okay, so we're going to do EDM drill called electronic drill. Now, we got to go for a subgenre. So it has to be something with jazzier chords, like seventh chords, because that's what I want to play. So first thing first, we're going to start with the super saw. Another trick is go to envelope 2, grab it, put it over your coarse pitch, give it a little attack. So there's that pitch bend sound. Another trick about EDM is you play the third up an octave. So instead of playing DFA, you would play DA and then F up an octave. It's hard to like change your mind to revoice it like that, but that's how they play the notes. DMX. DMX, what y'all really want? AKA Swiss Beats type beat. Boom, ka, 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 boom, ka, boom, ka, 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 boom, ka. That's the Swiss Beats rhythm. Okay. So I found the EDM also likes more like detuned to the left. They like that harsh sound. Let's try some chords. Let's see what chords sound like. Is that too jazzy? Let's give envelope 3 over the detune. Let's make that fade down a little bit. Let's do the opposite, actually. Let's make it fade up into detune. Okay, let's start there. So I got to turn off my mic real quick so it doesn't feedback. All right, so we have it all starts with music, and then you can make it EDM-esque. So we got over 80 people, so I'll continue this. So what we're making today is, I called it electronic drill. So I probably should have done the rhythm first, because drill music is very rhythmic based, and I didn't even think about that. So I might have to redo those chords to an EDM, to a drill rhythm. Tongue twisted over here. Now drill is tap, tap, tap. It's one, wait, now I'm, what's the drill rhythm? Tap, 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 tap. Okay, it's just three notes repeating. And let's add this in. Also, we got to go to 144 BPM, so that's definitely going to change the BPM. I mean, change the chords. Right, let's see what we could do. Now I got to play those same chords, but to this rhythm. I just realized the beat was... There we go. Microphone check. A section and B section. It's just having two different vibes that mesh. You could do different positions in the key. Like instead of starting at A in A minor, you could start at C, which is the relative key, like C major. So A section, B section is just about contrast. It's really no other scientific way to go about it. What else is in here? The low vibes. I don't know. I'm trying my hand. I haven't made EDM in so long. So we're just in part one. EDM has like thousands and thousands of components. So I'm trying to make it simple without spending a decade on this stuff. So we're trying to mix drill with EDM. We're going to call it electric drill.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
So now I'm going to get to the drill drums so I can lay the foundation for rhythm, and then we can go back to sound design because we got to add all the sparkle and stuff. Game Boy Advanced. That's funny. Trying to go EDM route. So EDM is all about using weird sounds. That's the whole EDM thing, and samples. I'll show you how to insert theirs. We're not yet. We'll insert those. We're not there yet.
Thank you.
Now I'm adding all the sparkly stuff. Sometimes making it too musical takes away from the hardness of drill, but I'll try reverse stuff. I'll try all the sparkly stuff added on top. You said Facebook Live was a good busy sound. Thank you. Yeah, we're just trying to, this is a live experiment right now. We're trying to blend two different genres together. It may or may not work. You never know. Best mastering AI is Isotope Ozone Master Assistant. Try that out. Isotope Ozone 9 Master Assistant. Cool static shot mode. All right, let me add all the sparkly stuff.
We'll be right back.
don't know. This is boring me to death. I'm trying to find little blips and bleeps and glitches. I feel like I'm missing to like a growl sound, some type of wow type of sound. So I'm going to switch it up. I'm going to take off the arpeggio. And why is it so low? Sounds super weird outside of arpeggio. I guess this does sound better in arp. Just feel like I'm missing something. It needs that like something. And I don't want to waste time looking for it. I don't know, not the most exciting genre to make. I just gotta be honest with you. It's just not exciting. Probably because I don't listen to this music. Just not excited by it. It's got to be completely transparent. Not excited by it. It is 1 a.m. I'm deciding if I want to stay here and make another track or drive home and do work on the computer. I'll do one more track. That track was such a letdown. I can't go out like that. The track was so boring. Check, check, check. It's a lesson that every track will not be super exciting. Is there a way to control the tempo on FPC? Can't match it. As, yeah. Like time stretch, you mean? That sounds like a niche problem. I would look in the forums. I don't think they have time stretch in FPC. Let's call this live stream energy because I need some energy. That last track put me to sleep. Bleepity bloop. Bloop bloop. Let's do something more upbeat. What is there to do? We've made almost everything. Let's go through Omnisphere. Whenever I'm bored, I go through Omnisphere. Actually, let's go to Ableton Live because I want to show you guys Hermes stuff. Because that track put me to sleep. Okay. Here's what I'm excited about is Hermes sounds. Let's pull up Hermes. Where is that? Plugins. Hermes. Technically called Hermes Synth, but I say Hermes for short. Named after the guy with the little staff. So I'm coming out with a new update soon enough. Just gotta make the sounds. I'm finishing up the effects and then I gotta figure out what type of sounds I wanna put in here. Let's pull up. Something more smoother, more harder. There we go. We'll use this, spread it out, and then let's run it through some new effects that I'm making for you. So with the new Hermes bundle, you'll have access to all this stuff, and if you already bought it, just ask my team. They'll check the receipt and they'll send you to the new download page. It's not out yet, but it will be. So let's go to user presets, audio, Narcos. So I've been making some crazy effects. So I'm going to start with the one called Ambient Creator. And this is for all the lo-fi folks out there. Let's create a return track. Do Ambient Creator. Let me put on my headphones real quick. So you can find Hermes at HermesPlugin.com if you're wondering. www.HermesPlugin.com. If you don't put the www, it will pull up an error page. So let's play this sound. Hermes has built-in effects too, by the way, if you didn't know. You can do stuff like this. Hold up. You can do the Travis Scott effect, the vibrato. You can do the spread effect, which is the one I like the most. So we're gonna mess with this one for a while. So let's send it to the new effects. It creates a whole environment around the sound. I'm holding one note. It creates birds chirping. It creates like a jungle forest type of sound. Do you think the music industry has a dark occult side? I think that's used for marketing. I don't think they really have a secret cult, no. So this is the cool part about ambient creator. Just has an environment type of sound to it. So that's one effect I'm really excited about. And you really don't even have to do much with these. You just gotta turn it on. So let's do the next one. This is called Astro World, named after the good old Travis Scott, and I mixed it with Juice WRLD's name, so it's Astro World together. So let's pick like a Juice WRLD-esque sound. Let's just pick a pluck. Okay, so let's pull it back from A, and now I'm running it through the Astro World combination here. So let's play. Turn this up a little bit. I think I gotta play faster. And you can go to the plugin, you could turn up stuff. Let me put the arpeggio on because I'm not playing fast enough here. Let's go to MIDI effects, arpeggiator, and let's put this on our Hermes track. So now, do this. It's like a pitch wobbly reverb type of sound. You can add the effect directly on too. You can put it directly on your track. I wouldn't recommend putting it directly on, but you can. So it gives you a different sound. Let's try direct Astro World sound. So it's like a certain type of reverb. It's like a pitch wobble reverb. Let's do the next one. It's called Bass Beefer. So this is for bass sounds. Run it through. Now this is a send effect, but you could use it direct. It's not really a bass sound, is it? I picked the most non-bass sound to do that demonstration. Let's do a bass sound. Let's try this one. So it pulls it up and then it just puts it in your face. Pause. Yeah, I don't stream like 12 hours in a row on Twitch. I don't know how folks do it. They're on Twitch like it's their job. So that's the bass beefer tongue twister. Oh, here's the one I wanted to pull up. Best of Both Worlds. That's the one. So here's the one that's a combination of Astro World and I forget the other one. It's like two in one. Here's the one I was trying to play before. Mix them up. Been making so much stuff, I forgot what the heck I made. Let me take off my effects just so you can hear the Ableton effects. So this will be free with the bundle for Hermes. And let me send it to the ARP, and then we'll send it to the new one called Best of Both Worlds. That's the sound that I'm remembering. Okay, there we go. So it adds a nice delay and a little reverb throw for you. Then we got Big Bales. This one is probably best to add directly on the track. Let me take off these arpeggios. I did not prepare this demonstration, as you can see. I got the worst presets to demo this stuff. I'm picking on the most random stuff. Let's do bells. Let's do a more musical bell. Let's try dark. All right. Big bells is a little hard to hear. I can't tell if that's the sound itself or the plug-in. Where's our... Oh, that's the sound itself. Why am I struggling? Help me out, y'all. Pick a patch that makes sense for the sound. Let's try this. Goodness. Okay, so big bells makes it bigger. Here's without. Here's with. Let's turn the volume down. I know what this does. This is for playing chords and then running it through some other sends. So again, here's without this plugin called Big Bells. It sounds good. But here's with Big Bells. A little chorusy twang in there. Just makes it spacey sounding. Get on your spaceship vibe with that one. That's called Big Bells. Now the next one is more for like sound designers. So this one creates a random response. So I'll show you what it is. It's called Crystal Ball. And if I send it to F, it creates like a random. So you're like, when would you ever use that? What I do is I tuck the return track and then I run it through all these other effects. So let's start just running it through all these effects returns. Play all them together. And now you get this huge sound. So really all these effects kind of stack up on each other. So this way you can expand on the Hermes presets. That's why I made these Ableton patches for you. Now it sounds super cinematic. You can turn up that crystal ball effect for this type. See how it just sounds like a texture as opposed to like this random staticky sound? So all these combined create a ridiculous sound. And that's the power of these Ableton effects. And I've only gone through six out of like 18. The other ones, I'll load up one more because I don't want to sit here and do every single one. And now let's combine all these together. So this one's called Twister. It's for just... So here's without. Sounds cool. Here's with the twister effect. It's like a chorusy delay effect. And then let's add everything together. So crystal ball is G. We got to keep that one down. And beef, we don't need that one. Turn this off. So all these combined. Let's play a chord. What chord are we playing? Let's just play the same chord we've been playing this whole time. That's what I've been working on. This way you can make your Hermes sound way different. And that's what I've been doing. So let's load up a brass patch just to show you this applies to almost every sound. Except bass, I would say. Like, that sounds wild. Here in Hermes. I'm telling you, all these effects are gonna be wild. You want the ambience off? Yeah, I'll turn the ambience off. Ambient generator just reminds me of like I'm in a jungle. Let's turn that one off, to be fair. So it just adds this unique texture. That's why I'm excited about these. Also, you could turn this, never mind, there's also macro controls. So if you want to turn stuff down, so for example, if the ambient is too heavy with the reverb, you could pull that back. You could turn the birds up if you want more birds. Like, I've literally created birds. I don't think y'all understand how difficult that is. That's so funny. I'll turn up these effects too. There's a laser effect in here. Alright, so that's what's coming out soon. I just wanted to give you guys a preview. Sounds like a Swiss beat. All right, so I'm gonna wrap it here since our audience is just going to sleep. It is late on a Saturday. Glad you could join me. I wanted to show off a couple things. I wanted to introduce you to products we have. 50% off everything. Use code 550 at busyworksbeats.com. Our premium stuff at busyworksbeats.com/premium is extremely affordable now. We have premium Shopify stuff is on sale, and I feel like I'm missing something. Oh, Mixed Genius is in the video description if you want to grab that. I marked it down. What else did we mark down? We're having a summer sale, and I don't even know my own deals. There's so much stuff to choose from. Yeah, I slept earlier, so I'm straight to drive. I had a little nap. And I feel like I'm missing something to tell you, and my brain is not pulling it from my memories. And what else? So Hermes is coming out soon. Hermes update. Appreciate y'all. I was taking it all in. Thank you. Appreciate you. And now I'm going to end this multi-stream. So we've been going for 3 hours.